Hello and greetings from Iceland. The Met Office just announced that the next eruption might be hours or days away, and they don't make serious statements like that unless they have a good reason for it, like GPS or satellite data, that is suggesting now that there is a new dose of magma in the magma chamber under Svartsengi near the Blue Lagoon, or 6.5 million cubic meters. So the next eruption could start anytime now. But when it comes to the details, that's when things get a bit more complicated, like we got 5 hours notice in the form of earthquakes before the last eruption. And scientists say now that this notice could be even shorter now, but never less than 1 hour. And the big question that remains is where? After listening to many experts, I can only say that this is a guessing game, although there are a few leads to follow. Like one of the questions out there is about the magma dike formed on November 10th. Can it be that it is already full of solidified magma, especially on the way from Svartsengi to Grindavík? And I wish it was the case. However, the Met Office expects the eruption to come up between those two mountains or by the south end of the fissure that erupted on December 21st. And eruption there would keep the new lava barriers busy. And strangely enough, the lava from the eruption in January could work as a barrier for lava coming from that direction, where the Met Office is talking about now, or at least up to some limit. However, when I use the webpage I'm linking to where I can see earthquakes hour by hour from raw data, it worries me to see earthquakes almost under the town. And I've even found earthquakes at a very little depth in the mountain pass between Grindavík and the Blue Lagoon or under the highway into the town. And this worries me because it's been going extremely slow to empty the houses in the town. It shouldn't be very complicated, but the planning turned out to be a bit too complicated for the civil defense. So there is a growing resentment among former residents. They have nothing to say about how the salvage operation is planned. And this is a town where people are used to get things done, even in some of the worst working conditions you can find in Iceland. And I understand it very well that they just want to take care of the planning themselves. But still, that's not an option. So it's a lot of work that's need to be done there. We know it for sure now that no one will live there for the next months or years. And the next eruption might as well take more houses. And I want to mention a trend that we started to see on the seismometers before the last eruption, or this lineup on Mount Fagradalsfjall, just about where the first eruption took place. My wishful thinking asked for the next eruption to take place there, of course, but the location seen from the drone is just about here. But it's more likely just some tension that has been transferred there from the Sundanhukar crater where it has been erupting. And talking about tension, in my last update where I covered the big picture, I mentioned a little science debate about the earthquakes that occurred last weekend, or were they due to magma movements or tension changes on the Reykjanes Peninsula. And it now seems as the Met Office got this right, since those earthquakes can quite easily be linked to a major fault that runs across the peninsula. It's a known fault where we get magnitude 6 plus earthquakes every 50 years or so, and the last such earthquake hit us in 1968, and before that in 1929. So the Met Office has been warning us to get ready for an earthquake, a big one. And luckily, we have strong houses here in Iceland. But when we look at this photo from 1991, the fault is up there in those mountains, Sulphur Mountains. And since this photo was taken, we have built the city even closer to the plate boundaries and this fault. And I actually don't have a good picture of this fault, but it is my plan to go up there next summer and do some filming, because we have some mighty impressive volcano formations there. Like if we look at this mountain pass here and I move you closer with footage from last summer, you understand why I want to go there filming. And when I turn around to the city, we see some very impressive lava fields. and from here lava has flowed all the way down to the sea. But back to the overview photo, but at the other end of the fault that runs across these mountains, we have this view from the south coast. And this is actually one of my many favorite places on the Reykjanes Peninsula. And never could have guessed 5 years ago that I would see a formation like this in the making on the peninsula. But I remember when I was driving by many times thinking, how would this look like a waterfall coming from the cliffs? And it looks like this. But back to Grindavík. One of the possible scenarios we have now is another dike intrusion, like on a November 10th, that didn't even end up with an eruption. In such case, the pressure would split the ground even more, tearing apart pipelines and cables, and we just got the news when some residents were picking up their belongings that there are many more houses that we can write off after the rifting that took place during the last eruption, or due to this additional ground displacement where we even got a new little valley through the town, over 30 centimeters deep. And that's the second one. So it has been extremely hard to keep up the water pressure, the hot water pressure in the houses. The hot water grid that keeps the houses warm, it's leaking like never before. Many of the houses in town are barely hot, but there has been a team of plumbers in town trying to salvage what can be salvaged. And I think they've done a good job. If not, the cold in January would have destroyed every house in the town. And we might have lost the town as a community for a long time, even for good. But if this horrible chapter that we are in now will leave something intact, there is no reason to let it rot. I still see a lot of purpose with this work, like to keep the electricity and the hot water grid working, because there might be a use for those houses later on, or usage possibilities that we don't see today, because we are too busy salvaging and worrying. Like someday, this could turn into valuable tourist infrastructure. So I'm finishing this today by the Blue Lagoon that remains open, and I'm not sure what to think of it. We know of this magma chamber under the area where the Blue Lagoon is, the magma chamber that has caused all these problems and is pressurizing now under several layers of aquifer systems, and the magma influx is more than ever now. But we put our trust in our scientists, and the Met Office is saying it's only a matter of days now, even hours. So I've been getting the question today why I'm not in Reykjavík already, but I just got back home north. And I have been wondering, should I drive to Reykjavík to be ready for the next eruption before it starts, or do like last time and do my announcement with the basic information and then hit the road? I'm not sure just yet. I might wait for the earthquakes to start and take off, but I have lots of work to do here in the north. Project that I've been throwing away when the volcano coverage has taken over my life from time to time. So I'm going to see how the evening and the night develops on the seismometers, and I think it's very likely that I will go as close to Grindavík as I can go this weekend, and come up with as good information and footage as possible. And with that, I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.